Several years ago, we recognized that immunotherapy was being effective for a number of other cancers. And not surprisingly, it tends to take a while until it filters down to the rare diseases. And we decided to sort of expedite that effort and try to get a better understanding of where neuroendocrine tumors should fit in the new emerging field of immunotherapy.
We were one of a number of folks who were supported by NetRF to look into a systematic approach of the immune system and trying to understand what cells are actually there and try to understand what they might be doing.
And we've been looking in detail at the immune landscape in neuroendocrine tumors in patients who are having surgical resections or biopsies for their disease.
What we found in some ways may not be surprising. Neuroendocrine tumors are different from other cancers in many different ways. So this story may be a little bit more complex than it is in other kinds of cancers.
However, there are, I think, some provocative and intriguing data that we've seen so far that suggest there may be ways to manipulate tumors and the immune system so that we can actually apply immunotherapy to this tumor type.
We've so far looked at about 40 patients with neuroendocrine tumors. And what we've identified to date is that there are immune cells around the tumor. They express molecules or receptors on the surface which potentially could be therapeutically targeted. The main challenge is actually getting these immune cells into the tumor to start attacking the cancer cells. What we don't understand at the moment is exactly what's preventing the immune cells from infiltrating into the tumor, and that's going to be the focus of the next part of our project.
In our work, what we've started to observe is that actually while most of the focus is on T cells, which are sort of the operative killers of the immune system, there may actually be an important role for some other types of immune cells called macrophages as well. And they're some of the foot soldiers that go out and digest invaders for us.
But I think we're starting to have an understanding as to why this standard off-the-shelf drugs probably not going to be sufficient for neuroendocrine tumors.
And NetRF is certainly funding a number of projects aimed at doing this so that we can actually, as the saying goes, make a cold tumor hot, meaning a tumor that we think may not respond to immunotherapy now will respond to immunotherapy.
You know, I'm hopeful that over the next decade we'll be bringing clinical trials in that will allow us to leverage the immune system and probably in a different way than we do in other tumors, to try and get some of our patients to have longer-term durable remissions and maybe one day even cures.